Hey guys, it's Jeff, and today we're talking about iOS 13 Beta 4, talking about any possible new features and changes that we might be seeing, and also covering the release date that we should be expecting iOS 13 Beta 4. So let's go ahead and get into it with the new features. Now, as far as new features go, I'm not really expecting anything much. We've gotten a lot of new features in Beta 1 and Beta 2, and as far as iOS 13 goes, there's not really too much to ask for when it comes to new features. I think we're doing pretty well so far. Now, as far as any possible new features that we might be seeing, it's stuff that we've already been told and stuff that we've already been seeing within the iOS family. So the first thing that we're going to be talking about is the phone app and more spam call integration. We obviously have the call blocking feature where if the number is not recognized or not in your contacts, that the call doesn't go through, it's just silence. But I do expect to see the spam call detection being tested in the developer betas at the very least. We might not see it in the public betas, but who knows? Apple might surprise us, but this seems like a feature that needs to be tested before it's released. So hopefully we do see that spam call detection in the beta process here, hopefully in beta 4 or beta 5, but I do fully expect to see it in at least a few betas before it comes out later this fall, which is when Apple said this feature would be coming to Apple devices. Although that might be the case where, you know, we might not get a beta, we would see it with the new iPhones, but I do hope that they do beta test that, because any new feature like that definitely needs to be tested by developers or the public at the very least. Now, some other possible new features, these are very far out, is an iPadOS style home screen where you have the widgets on one side, maybe in little blocks, kind of like what we see in the control center. But that I highly doubt that would be coming to the iPhone lineup, or kind of like the iDevice lineup of the mobile, kind of like mobile phones, the iPods and everything like that. I don't think that's going to be coming. But what I do expect is further customization to the home screen. I do think that is going to be coming. I think that Apple did a very good job with iPadOS and kind of allowing those widgets to come in. I think that has a lot of us asking for at least some further customization options when it comes to moving apps around, maybe having some more shortcuts control where you can, you know, make some stuff that would play well with your home screen. I'm not exactly sure, but do expect the home screen UI to maybe change just a little bit, maybe new app icons for Apple, Apple apps, and then also further customization to the control center UI. But that's about it as far as any new features. But I think the changes is really what we're going to be focusing on here. The changes to the UI as a whole. Obviously with iOS 13, they wanted to separate iOS 13 versus iOS 12, and I expect to see more UI changes coming within iOS 13, specifically in the Mail app as well. The Mail app has been well outdated for a very long time. I do expect that new app icon for the Mail app to be a little bit more modern looking, and then obviously the UI just needs to be a little bit more streamlined to be a little bit more modern and less apart from iOS 12 and iOS 11 and kind of all the previous versions of iOS where it's kind of looked the same. Now, the next thing I do expect to see is maybe some early beta testing for Apple Arcade. Fingers crossed for that. It looks like a very cool feature or kind of platform within the App Store, and I do expect some beta testing to be going on for that. Or if Apple is doing it internally, we'll just see the official release later this fall. Now, one thing that does need a change, maybe some further optimization, is the swipe to text keyboard. So swipe to text is working quite well, but I noticed that Apple obviously hasn't been in this game for a very long time. Devices like Samsung, Google, their devices are very streamlined for this feature. Apple's is not really. So I do expect to see some further optimization where text is recognized as to where you actually want to go with the swipe to text. Right now, it seems a little bit too fast. It seems like your iPhone is basically guessing a little bit too much, and you're getting the wrong wording. So hopefully there's some further optimization on that. And then speaking of further optimization, I think, you know, definitely some more optimization to the TrueDepth sensor and really Animoji, Mumoji, and kind of getting those a little bit more streamlined. I noticed in the third beta, everything just seems a little bit more jittery with Animoji and Mumoji. In beta 1 and beta 2, it was very smooth. But in beta 3, even the second version, things were just a little bit more jittery. So I do expect to see kind of a more smooth experience when dealing with Mumoji and Animoji with that TrueDepth sensor. Now, another thing that we should expect for Mumoji is just further customization. Not much of a big deal there. We've already gotten a lot in beta 1, beta 2, and beta 3 of Mumoji customization, which has been absolutely amazing, but just do expect a few more options here and there as we move on in the beta process. Another thing is new emoji. I'm not going to speak too much on that, but we are expecting new emoji. We've been expecting it for a while, and I do expect to see those in the betas here. Now, let's move on to speed and performance, because that is very important when it comes to the betas, especially after seeing the first version of beta 3 be very buggy and almost unusable for most users. So beta 1, beta 2 performance was very good. Once we saw like kind of the speed ramping up to where Apple was saying, hey, we might get up to 2 times faster performance. Obviously they tried their hand at that moving up into the third beta where they wanted to really speed things up, but it kind of backfired and everything was very unstable. Now, the second version of beta 3 was very, very stable and actually was very fast. I did a video yesterday on the 2 times performance that you could possibly see within iOS 13. Definitely in our test, the performance has grown significantly even over the first and second betas. So go ahead and check that video out if you want to check out speed and performance on beta 3. It was very, very good. But I do expect for the fourth beta for a huge kind of focus to be on stability. Apple does not want to repeat having to release 2 versions of the same beta. I think stability is going to be a focal point when it comes to beta 4. Now, expect to see more speed and performance gains, but maybe at a slower rate, just because we saw that huge jump in performance and obviously stability was just not there in beta 3. So expect minimal kind of steps being taken within the next couple of betas, beta 4, beta 5, beta 6, and then kind of more further stability as the betas go on. Now, speaking of consistency, we do expect to see a more consistent Face ID activation. Face ID is obviously much faster on iOS 13 versus iOS 12, but it's not as consistent. A lot of times when I hold the phone up to my face, it just won't read. But when it does read, it's very, very fast. So hopefully kind of Apple fixes these issues within iOS 13 to make Face ID consistently fast. I'm not saying that it's not fast, just it needs to be a little bit more consistent. Now, also in regards to speed and performance, just the performance of the battery life just needs to be a tad bit better. I do expect to see better battery optimization kind of charging as we move on into the future of betas here, but do expect to see some better battery life as we move on. Of course, in smaller steps, just getting the kind of coding for the CPU single core and multi-core operations to be a little bit more efficient, not necessarily faster, but just a little bit more efficient. Now, let's move on to the dates that we should be seeing these betas. Obviously, very important here as we move on into the beta schedule. We still are on the 2-week schedule, and I do expect to see that 2-week schedule continue up until like beta 5 or beta 6. So since we are almost 2 weeks away here, just next Monday and Tuesday would be the expected dates for beta 4. So the 15th or the 16th of July here. So do expect to see the fourth developer beta on those dates. Now, as far as a third public beta, Apple seems to be following a schedule of releasing the public betas a week after the developer betas, just to shore up any bugs that are found in the developer betas that might hinder use for the public. So do expect the third public beta to be coming on like the 22nd, 23rd. That would be not next Monday, but the Monday or Tuesday after. So do expect a release on the 22nd or 23rd for the third public beta. So guys, that was kind of like all the new features, changes, maybe some focuses on speed and performance that we might be seeing in beta 4, and then of course a release date. If you have any comments, questions, or anything like that of what we talked about today, make sure to leave those in the comment section down below. And I do encourage you to go ahead and watch that speed and performance video that I did on iOS 13. The results were actually really, really good. So go ahead, check out that video. It will be linked in the video description below. Of course, if you you want to stay up to date with all of our content, make sure to get subscribed and also hit the bell button to get updates as soon as any of that content is released. So guys, thank you for watching this video, and hopefully I'll be seeing you in some upcoming content. Peace.